across an empty land.
This was Keane on STV in April 2004, on the cusp of success, having had a hit with Somewhere Only We Know. Speaking to Scotland Today at the time, lead singer Tom Chaplin couldn't believe they'd finally made it.
Did you sort of imagine being in the charts one day and it's all kind of a bit of a dream? When it happens, you know, it's just bizarre, ridiculous.
Now, nearly 3 years on, and the band have sold more than 6 million albums, won 2 Brit Awards and a prestigious Ivor Novello Award for songwriting. Their recent UK tour has been a sellout, and that's a trend that was first set in Scotland when the band were starting out.
Yeah, I mean, the first time we ever sold out a venue was at King Tut's Wawa.
Yeah.
And it was also the first time we ever had that kind of reaction where we felt like people had really made this incredible kind of emotional connection with our music and were singing the songs. There's just this kind of vibe in the room that we've never forgotten, and we get the same, you know, every time we come back. So we're delighted. There's just something about the atmosphere of playing this in this country, you know.
Is this true? Because I interviewed the Kaiser Chiefs this week as well. I mean, is it true? Come on, you're not just saying it.
If you ask any band about playing in Scotland, they all just go that they love it. You know, it's the same for Tea in the Park, it's the same for gigs, you know, it's just a wicked place to play music.
And there's already talk about a third album that you've apparently written 15 tracks for it and stuff like this. Have you? Tell us about it.
That sounds like one of those rumours that sort of
it's probably fairly true,
a germ of truth. Yeah, I mean, what we've done with this record, or with the ideas for the next record, is just to try and get the songs that we have at their very kind of inception. So just piano and voice. A lot of the lyrics aren't finished. A lot of the structures aren't kind of finished. But we want to take them at that very kind of raw moment, and then take them into the context of just working them into songs as the three of us. Because the last record, we kind of did it the other way around. We had finished songs, and we kind of went into a studio in a mad rush and kind of laid everything down that way. But I think this time we want to make it, you know, just, well, I mean, a lot of bands say this, but organic. You know, just really start from the. From the very roots and just build it up and see where we go. I think that kind of adventure is something that's really exciting us again. So that's the plan for this record.
Now, what about guitars? We were having a laugh earlier and I said, there's a guitar from the non-guitar playing band. But I mean, will you see a change in your sound, do you think? Are you quite, you know?
To be honest, we haven't really thought about the sound. I mean, Tom's been playing guitar live just on a couple of acoustic songs, and it's, you know, it's just cool for the crowd. It's something, you know, we'd like to keep ourselves on our toes and get people singing along to Tom playing the guitar. So I don't know, we'll use whatever, you know, we feel the song needs, but we really have, you know, not got a clue what the record's going to sound like. We just know that it won't sound the same as the last two, because, you know, we just love bands that try and do, you know, push themselves.
Yeah, I mean, that element of surprise is something that, you know, we're as excited about as our fans. You know, we want to surprise ourselves by creating something completely different, and you know, in turn, that's the way that you give your fans a shock.
And you, this is an old territory, your old stomping ground, Edinburgh. You studied art history?
I did art history, yeah, for a year here. And then I kind of hot-footed it back down to London to hook up with Tim and Richard and sort of have a proper go at making music. But it was a real wrench to leave, because I just loved the place. You know, it had an incredible nightlife, and you know, just the kind of spirit of sort of freedom and sort of liberation that you have when you first get to university is a great thing. So it was hard, but you know, music was always the thing that was kind of flowing through my veins, and I knew that you know, as much as I was loving it up here, I had to go and kind of make tracks with the rest of my life. And it was a gamble, but thankfully one that worked out.
And the best thing and the worst thing about touring?
I got a stomach bug the other night, so
well, yeah, when one person gets ill, everyone gets ill, because you're on this confined bus. The best thing about it is just seeing the world. I mean, we're off to South America. You know, who'd have thought that when we came and played our first ever show in Scotland, who'd have thought that eventually one day it would lead us to South America and playing in Chile and Brazil and Argentina. And, you know, it's just, that's just an amazing life.
Yeah. Do you still pinch yourself?
Yeah, I think that's the thing. You're constantly looking for things that are going to give you that buzz, you know. I mean, it's obviously, you know, you get used to playing in sort of small venues, and then it gets bigger and bigger, and the whole time, you know, you are having to pinch yourself. It's that kind of exhilarating feeling that you get from sort of moving forwards and becoming a bigger and bigger thing. So there are lots of things that keep doing that to us.
Yeah, I mean, like this, for example, we've just been playing an arena tour, and we're back into like a sweaty rock club, which actually is really exciting for us, because it's just about the three of us all stripped down and just, you know, going to make a rock show, you know, in a big smelly black room. So you know, that's what it's about.
It's nice to come back to this kind of intimate, kind of sweaty environment, you know, and you can really see everyone's, you know, expressions and reactions to everything. It's a very kind of raw, sort of visceral experience.
So, and we're in Scotland, excited. So we'll probably get some quality heckling as well, which is always better in a small venue, because then everyone can hear it.
So. We are the hardest audiences to please, apparently, so that's
they're the best.
The most rewarding as
exactly.
Well.
Exactly.
Brilliant stuff. It's been lovely speaking with you guys.
Thank you.
All the best. Cheers.